What's up, YouTube? This is Vorpal Blade, and welcome to episode 19 of V&D's multiplayer Minecraft adventure. And this Dan, what are you doing? Why are you looking at me like that? What's up, YouTube? This is Vorpal Blade, and welcome to episode 19 of V&D's multiplayer Minecraft adventure. In this episode, we're going to do something a little bit different. You know that server that we were telling you guys about that we would eventually give you the IP to? Guess where we're at. That's right. Today, we are going to give you a tour of the multiplayer server, not our private one, mind you, but the one that we very first started playing in. Recently did a reset, and now we've got a whole bunch of new stuff set up, and we are ready for new people to come in. It's already been set up for a couple weeks, but the name of the server is Deviant Evil.
Months. It's been up for a few months.
Yeah, a couple months. But we're going to give you guys a quick tour of the spawn in our area, and at the end of the video, we will give you guys a link to where you can put in an application. And where you can, if you are accepted, which you more than likely will, as long as you're not, like, a known griefer, you guys can come to the server, talk to us, check out our buildings, and even play with us, maybe. Who knows? But, pretty much, just wanted to give you guys an opportunity to come, like, you know, and hang out with us and see what we're up to, like, you know, when we're not actually putting episodes out. So, Dan...
I'd like to also state that to get on the server, it's a mature-based server, so it's not really, if you're a younger age, you more than likely can get on as long as you can show that you're a mature person.
We've had 12-year-olds on here that have acted more mature than 18-year-olds, so pretty much let me put it like this. As long as you act like an adult, we should not have an issue with you on the server. Also, there's a few other rules. So you guys want to make sure that you read up on that before you actually come in.
It's actually a requirement before you're allowed onto the server to have read all the rules.
Mm-hmm. Yep. No griefing or you will be fried. I wonder whose building that is.
Whoa, what happened here? There's like floating chests over here.
Oh.
That person planted all their grass. That's cool. That's something we need to do, area. I need to go through and just bone mill the heck out of our area.
Especially in my, I don't think we should bone meal everywhere because that'll detract from the areas that, like, you know, need it most. Like, my cube. The central park of our area.
I still need to finish this gas station. This will eventually be my, like, near spawn shop.
Because we've got the economy thing set up in here.
Yeah, and our place is, like, pretty far from spawn. This is a subway system that I'm working on underneath the gas station here.
Hmm.
This is going to be the regular way down that. Right now it's kind of temporarily right here.
Hey, whatever works. Geronimo!
Yeah, I'm working on it.
Oh, wow, that's a really tight, constricted space.
Yep.
War. By the way, guys, I want to vote. I want all of our subscribers and all of our viewers. Should I keep that skin that I had on at the beginning of the video? Because I want to know. What do you guys think? Haha! Click.
Did you get both cards?
I might have. I'm sorry.
Let's see how far this takes us before it stops. Because Notch messed with the minecart systems and, well, they're really buggy.
Yeah, how he said that he made minecarts faster, or minetrack boosters faster. Man, this worked perfectly fine with the old underpowered boosters. Now it's just kind of... it's not having slowdowns and all kinds of crazy crap.
I'm running out of juice.
I'm running out of juice, too. See, originally... We had this set up to where, like, you know, it would work just fine with, like, you know, the old,
And it didn't miss a beat. Like, it would go full speed the whole way, too.
Yeah. Okay, Hold on.
What are you doing? Oh, chunk error?
Chunk error.
He will be right back. There he is.
Haha.
Are you still recording?
Yeah, it never stopped recording. And you know what? Cool. We don't even have to do a cut because everybody's going to know this IP by the time that the video gets out. Move, Dan! Move! Get off the track! Wait.
Oh. Well, I'm having chunk errors anyway. I see squids floating in air, so yeah.
Yeah. Woo. It goes so fast.
Let me push. You're going as fast as I'm walking, just so you know.
I know.
Here, I'll push you.
Not anymore. That's right. That's right, Dan. Push.
I feel like a mining slave.
Oh, man. Push harder, slave.
I'm pushing.
Faster.
Whoa. Look at like a big bolt of speed there.
I don't know what Notch did to mess with this code, but it's really driving me crazy.
Can we have the other coder back, the one that usually fixed problems instead of...
Jeff.
I mean, no offense, Notch has an amazing game here, but he's got a lot of things to learn still, apparently, with coding. I mean, there's... When you create as many bugs as you attempt to fix is wow.
Mm-hmm. And I'm really glad you're pushing me along here because I got, like, a couple of chunk errors. I believe I can fly. Woo! I believe I can touch the sky. Okay, I'm done. Whoa! Ah! Where am I going?
I don't know. That's not supposed to be like that.
Maybe that...
You need... Where's that? There's a reset switch up here. You gotta put that card on.
Oh, yeah.
So you can reset it to,
Is that the one right there?
Yeah, it's supposed to be naturally reset, but since, like, where are you going?
Isn't that the right way?
Oh, I got a card. I can do it. No, the reset switch is over here, though.
Red is us, right?
Yes. That should have reset this. Okay, good, it did.
It's like going back and forth.
I had to reset the track because where it's all messed up and it's not going where it's supposed to go and... This whole subway system is being completely useless right now. I gotta come down here and pretty much triple the boosters. Put like three times as much boosters down here.
Wow.
Whose dogs are these?
These? I have no idea. They're probably Onyxes.
Yeah, they're not mine.
Wow, Dan. That's not how you spell route.
Well, you can do that. You're the spelling person.
Oh god.
Ooh, it's raining. Look at this wonderful lush grass.
Thank you, Notch.
I'm glad he did that so that people who have worlds already generated without grass can still grow it.
Yep.
But beforehand, that was the way to get grass was to blow up your world and make a new one.
Indeed. Wow.
Anyway. We're in our area now.
Indeed.
This is particularly my little section with the skyscraping towers. I got three towers. I got the wooden tower. This one right here is actually the first tower I've ever built. This is my first superstructure. Granted, it's been modified and upgraded over time, but this is my first actual building I can say I've built in Minecraft, period. Then I built this tower on Bucksville, or one equivalent to this, my Bucksville server. And, well, that server's just too crowded for me. I never really enjoyed overcrowded servers and having to pay to go to play on the laggy server. Nah, I'm not up for that. And this is my third tower ever built. This was on a more of a private server, but it was a really interesting server, how they had a customly generated section of map to where diamonds were basically as common as dirt. And this is my lab. It used to be different, but the version of the map that we recovered from back when the server got blown up was really old and I didn't have my lab, so I rebuilt it to be a little bit different. Where are you at?
I am actually having serious lag issues.
I am too. I don't know. What's the deal? It could be the combination of grass and rain.
It could be. Like, hold on. I'm not lagging as bad now that I'm away from your... I bet it's your tree farm.
I bet it, you know, I was about to say, because there was a bunch of trees down there that we just recently cut, and we just re-entered the area so that they were redoing the thing, and now it's not laggy, so hopefully whatever was down there causing lags. I have a tree farm that is notorious for causing lag. It's such an epic tree farm. Where are you going?
I'm walking towards you.
No, you're not. I'm way behind you.
Oh, wow. The lag is that bad?
I'm behind you.
Oh, wow. All right, let's walk over to my area where it's not so super laggy.
Okay.
All right.
I don't know about you, Troop. I'm walking towards your area now. And now you're walking towards mine.
I'm walking towards my area.
Okay, I'm just going to pretend. I'm going to log out and log back in.
Probably a good idea. Hold on. Okay, back to 30 frames per second.
Yeah, I'm not going to be cutting trees down that fast anymore.
Right. This is now the beginning of my area. This is a park that I've been working on. This is my cube. And it is a shrine to how awesome the cube is, because our heart's nice and portal.
We had the big one that you made in your single-player world, but apparently that was not approved.
Yeah, there's even a tip for the server. Giant 42x42 companion cubes are not allowed. I was like, oh. Oh yeah, I finally finished that thing. I just never uploaded a video for it. I hope I still have that save file on my laptop. But yeah, this is my park.
What is that? What is this structure looming way over here in the horizon? You want to share that one? Or keep that a secret?
That one over there? We'll tell them about that later. That'll be the last structure of theirs that I show. Alright. Last structure of mine, rather. This is the Vorpal Mansion right here. This is my house. This is the first structure that I made on this server after the reset. Over here, I get in
my log, notice that's a public wooden door is locked by his whammy. So I guess you have it locked where only you can use it. But since I'm an admin, I can use them?
I guess so, yeah. Here's my pool. It's quite luxurious, my mansion. Even with the high dive. Got all my doggies.
We actually modeled this house off of a picture we found on Google.
Mm-hmm. It's a really nice house. And with all the glowstone, like, when it becomes night, it literally glows in the dark. It's absolutely awesome. I love this house.
It's a radioactive house.
Practically.
And if you're wondering, how can you tell when you're in our little custom area that we pretty much claim for ourself here? We have a giant wall around it. It says that it's at city limits. I can't exactly
remember. Federation of Windurst. Yes. And for those of you who know what that is from, serious brownie points.
That's the name of our town is Windurst.
Indeed. Like,
or our city.
Man, I had fences right here for a really cool looking fireplace, but then Notch made them so they burn. Anger.
It's getting dark out.
Hello, Steve 2. How you doing, Steve 2? You doing good?
Come on. Can I push her on fire?
It's a good boy. What? No, don't you dare. I will hurt. I swear to God, Dan. I swear to God. If you hurt Steve, too, I will destroy you. You hear me? Destroy.
Just so you know, PvP is installed.
I know.
So don't hit me with that thing.
Grr. Get away from Steve, too. Grr.
I am away.
I will hurt you. All right, let's go upstairs and show him my lab. Should we show him
your lab?
Should we show him the experimental area? Why did I just hear some glass break?
Because I threw it in front of your door to try to block you out.
Oh. For a second, I thought you broke my glowstone. Oh yeah, glowstone is a.
It now requires a pickaxe to break.
Mm-hmm. This is the beginnings of my lab. Once again, I had fences and fire all around this lip, but they all burnt down. So,
that looks like a giant piston.
Indeed. I need to fix it. And I need to make these doors. I haven't decided how I want them to work yet, so.
So now your way of getting in is removing the wool.
Indeed. I haven't. I got my rafters here, which I'm going to do rows of torches onto. But, like, I really haven't worked on the second story or anything in here just yet. This is the last thing that I was working on before we moved. By the way, anybody who's actually curious, the apartment is awesome. Absolutely awesome.
It's still unfinished. I'd really love to be able to get, you know, a couple shelves up and be able to get my containers of objects out of boxes and whatnot. Be able to access them easily.
Yeah, but we're waiting till the landlord finishes up the work in the apartment, and then yay!
Hopefully that'll be tomorrow.
Indeed.
And then my carpet needs to be fixed because whoever installed it, erg.
Does this design right here look familiar to you guys? This is a monster spawner. And it's a monster spawner trap. Yeah, this is the same exact design we showed you guys on one of our more recent episodes. Although we have to change a couple things. And this is my way of killing Dan because he's placing glass behind me.
Hey,
run away. And down here is my piggy grinder. No piggies are spawning. I want them to die in a fire in true aperture fashion so I can gather cooked pork chops. But they're not spawning. It's making me sad face, and I don't know why.
Pork chops.
It's in a lit up grassy area. Why they're not spawning, I have no idea. It's starting to make me sad. Anybody?
There's nothing spawning down here.
And what I got down over here is another mob spawning trap. This one's for zombies, though. Zombies.
This one's turned on.
This one is turned on.
Here's a collection-y area.
Indeed. So that's Aperture. We're actually going to build the PvP arena on this server now instead of on our Let's Play, our private server. That way it'll be operational between other people rather than just me and Dan. And I think I'm really looking forward to that.
Should somewhere we're going to build it.
Oh yeah, I guess we should. We can go around the building.
Yeah, let's do that.
Prepare thine weapon, good sir. For monsters be about this area.
I have my weapon selected. Love how my tower's glowing. Just see on the hillside there. My weapon is arrows. I throw them.
This is where the arena is going to be. It's a huge, flat area that Dan cleared out by hand by himself.
Took way too long.
Indeed.
Took 2 days.
And let's show him my final structure, and then, by then, hopefully...
Oh, we still got a couple more things this way.
Oh, do we?
Yeah, the other part, my single-player world, and the shack.
Oh, well,
and the mall, and the incompleted mall that I need to finish.
Oh yeah, you got a spider behind you.
Yep, I see.
And a creeper and bones,
and right. Everything else.
All right, Dan, going into man mode.
I can't see because the world. I'm running faster than the world's looting.
That's cool. I killed the creeper and the skeleton.
Ow. Okay, cool. I'm glad I knew about where this was.
And I killed the spider that was after you too.
Okay. I wish the world would hurry up and load because I'd like to know where I'm going.
I'd like to know where you are.
I went through the tunnel.
Oh, there you are. Serious man mode. Spider killing.
This is a really awesome temple that's in the works. It's incomplete right now, but once this is complete, it's going to be like a labyrinth type style thing. And once it's set up, we'll have, you have to ask for permission first, but you'll be able to run through it and get a reward at the end. This is still loading.
Dan,
come on, hurry up.
I don't know where you are.
I just walked right by you. I'm right behind you.
Oh, there you are.
But this right here is going to be the mall. Like we said, the server has an economy, and I'm going to have it set up to where we can have, you know, people set up shops here and whatnot, and be able to sell things. I'm not very satisfied with the inner walls. It just seems like they're kind of... I mean, they're okay, but it just seems kind of cheapy, fabricated type. It seems like the building was... Downstairs, I'm okay with.
It looks but the good
upstairs one. Yeah, the upstairs one seems kind of ugh. This one is going to be the admin shop, so this one's going to be all one big shop type thing. Mm. But these up here... Whoa, creeper just... Hello, creeper. Okay, sure, whatever. Creeper had to do his late-night shopping. I guess this will work. The thing that just really bugs me is how this shop and the other shop across it don't have a real wall. They just have a fence between the two.
I like that. It looks cool.
It does. But you wouldn't find anything like that in real life.
No, you wouldn't. But then again, you wouldn't find a lot of things in Minecraft like you would in real life. Even though that's kind of the theme of the server.
Anyway, we should mention that. The server strives to try to keep things lifelike. So if you want to join the server and build a giant, like, you know, one-by-one tower with lava flowing off of it, no. That ain't gonna happen.
Yeah, unfortunately. But hey...
Unfortunately? What do you mean, unfortunately? That's... Personally, that doesn't seem very attractive. It's just a big glowing rod. It's a lightsaber.
That's what she said. No, I'm done.
If you have a glowing rod...
Winder's Mall, but here it doesn't say Winder's Mall. Here it says...
Mall Winder's. Yeah, I need to work on this. I need to make it two... I'm going to make it two layers thick.
Yeah, that way so it says Winder's Mall on the other side, too.
Exactly.
Yeah, good idea. And that's your single-player world thing that you made, right?
Yeah, that was my on my single-player world, and before we launched this map, I imported it.
Because you wanted all your special buildings all in one area.
Yeah, why isn't... I never finished this pathway.
No, you didn't.
I moved it out so I could have that sign up there, but never finished it. And I need some health.
Get some pork chops.
I don't have any. Do you have anything on you?
I got gunpowder. You can eat that. Yes,
let me eat the gunpowder.
It won't restore your health, but it'll make you feel like a
man. I might have something in my single player ward. Oh, wait. The stairs are broke. Or my ladders are broke. That was back when water ladders worked.
Yeah, you got a lot of fixing up to do on this guy.
I wonder. Oh, God.
You're entering the nether?
I think. I'm trying. Whoa, that's glitchy. Like, it tries. It just, like, gives me the purple swirls and doesn't send me anywhere.
Excuse me, let me try. Although I'm probably going to regret this.
It's a trippy machine.
Oh, God. That's it?
Where's the rest of my bridge?
Whoa.
I know, it's a trippy machine, right?
Dude. dude, these mushrooms I took, man. Send me on a serious trip, dude. No. Wow. No, for real, that kind of gave me, like... That made my head spin in, like, real life. Wow. Yeah. Wow. That was extreme.
I got some bread. I guess I could eat that. Very single-player stuff.
Zombie body!
This bread is really stale.
Super stale.
I got some pork chops, too. I'm fine now. I'm just half-heartedness in here.
I want to get a texture pack that makes skeletons stormtroopers because they have about that good of a name.
That would be awesome.
That would be awesome. Like, not change much other than just make skeletons stormtroopers. That is still not loading.
Come on, Notch. Fix this. He's spending too much time playing Terraria and not fixing Minecraft.
Can you blame him? There's a lot of things on Terraria that should be implemented in Minecraft, but then again, there's a
like
lot
the world
of stuff
actually
in
loading.
There's a lot of stuff that Minecraft does way better than Terraria.
The building aspect of Minecraft just pones Terraria.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely destroys it. Also, the method of getting on the servers and hosting servers and playing on servers, period, destroys Terraria too. I wonder if that tip about Steve is still on there. Because I want to hurt Onyx for that.
Do you not want the tip on there anymore?
No, I do, because it's hilarious. And it'll give people, like, you know, a laugh every time they see it, but it makes me so sad. But it's okay, because now I have Steve, too.
You guys might remember this.
Indeed. Ah, the shack.
With broken ladders.
Hooray.
We temporarily placed the dirt block down there so we can access it.
Yep, because now you can't use ladders unless they're, like, absolutely together all the way. Thanks, Notch. Not really. Oh, well. I wonder if we can get up there by jumping. Up. Yep. Yep. No. Not possible.
Was there something in that?
I don't know.
No. All these chests are empty. Oh, yeah, it's because we originally had it down there, and it was the actual imported one. But then you're like, no, I don't want that there, because I want to build something else there. So I moved it up here. It's actually better up here anyway.
It is a lot better up there.
It's my little mountain lodge.
I think having a replica of the shack up there is pretty freaking sweet, if you ask me.
You guys know how he said we're going to build, like, a monument to the Lightbringer?
That's what that is.
Well, I can't see anything because my world is still loading.
Oh, I can.
But that tower that's right there, that should be right there, but waiting for the world to load just so I could see it.
Hey, just flip to my screen because it's here.
Yeah. Is yours having loading issues like mine is?
Nope. Dan's Tower, 3.1, home of the Lightbringer.
It's still incomplete. I've got so much work to do.
Indeed.
But down there is where it's going to be. I'm going to have it like on a pedestal. And I see a skeleton up there, or zombie or something. But yeah, there's an actual light source coming from outside that's going to be there. So it's going to be like brighter than everything else. And there's going to be like a pedestal, pretty much type thing. It's going to be like a half steps for the most part for the center. And then at the very center, there's going to be a chest. And inside the chest is going to be the Lightbringer.
Awesome.
Until we can actually have, like, a stone in a pedestal type thing.
That'd be awesome. Like, have, like, sword in the stone / master sword type stuff. That would be absolutely awesome.
Having items in, a decorative type form would be really awesome. Like, you take glass blocks and items and you craft them, and it puts the items in the glass.
Yeah.
So you can place those blocks just for decorative purposes, and you break the glass, it gives you the item back.
That would be awesome. Like, kind of like having it in a jar, but a glass jar.
Exactly.
That would be... Wow, I wonder if we could send that to, like, Yogscast or something, where, like, Notch could possibly hear the idea. Because I know Notch listens to the Yogscast.
So he doesn't watch anyone else's videos?
I don't know, he might. Like, I seriously doubt Notch will watch our videos. Dan, it's over this way.
I can't tell where I'm going, because... My super slow. If I find the wall, I'll just follow the wall and eventually find it.
Dan. Stop.
Yes.
Stop. Stop. Stop.
Stop what?
Alright. Alright.
Just stop watch. That way.
Dan. You're right next to it. Log out and then log back in so your chunks load correctly.
That just gets annoying. There we go.
Alright.
Sort of, kind of.
And
there we go.
Here is the very latest structure that I've been working on. Oh, intimidating. It's nowhere near complete. But this is my pagan tower to the creeper god. It originally started because Dan and I had this conversation about how much I love dirt and how I said dirt is awesome and dirt is pretty looking. Look at that. That's beautiful. That is an absolutely beautiful tower right there. That brown, that's a nice color brown. You guys know it looks awesome. And I was originally just going to make... Oh, that's awesome! Yes! we should do that all the way up around the ring outside of it.
Oh, that's you.
Oh, man, I am so excited about this. But yeah, this is kind of like a nature tower / homage to the creeper. And I've got a lot of work to do to this. Oh yeah, featuring Emo Creeper here too. Originally, I was going to have a creeper up there that had lava pouring out of its mouth coming all the way down. But man, the server admin, for the purpose of preventing griefing, has it so that lava doesn't flow. And, like, while I'm kind of like, yeah, I can see that still, I'm super sad, because while lava very rarely should be used for decorative purposes, that would just be so cool.
Oh.
At least I got emo creeper. Emo creeper. Dan, is that everything?
That's everything I can think of.
All right, guys. Well, we're gonna post all the information that you guys need to join us on this server. Come check us out, talk to us, and even build some stuff of your own. We'll post all that information you will need in the comments in the info section of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed this, and we will see you guys next time.